Welcome to the xMac Studio Quick Start Guide. First, remove the three silver thumb screws, securing the Echo module. Slide the Echo module out of the front of the enclosure. Following the user's guide, install your PCIe cards into the Echo module. Slide the Echo module back into the enclosure. Secure the Echo module with the three silver thumb screws you removed previously. If you're going to install an SSD, remove the two screws that hold the airflow integrity cover using a Phillips number 1 screwdriver. Remove the white magnetic tape backing and attach it to your SSD. For smaller SSDs, you may need to use sharp scissors to trim the magnet to fit. Repeat the last step when you are installing two SSDs. Insert the SSD into the accessory space. The magnet will secure the SSD during transport. Feed your SSD cables through the airflow integrity cover, with the slots facing down. Secure the airflow integrity cover with the screws you removed previously. Remove the front plate by unscrewing six black thumb screws on the front of the xMac Studio enclosure. Slide in your Mac Studio. The nylon guides will protect the finish. Secure the front plate to the enclosure with the six black thumb screws. To improve Bluetooth reception in rack environments, check out the Sonnet long-range USB Bluetooth micro adapter. Attach a rack gear on each side of the enclosure with four screws using a Phillips number 2 screwdriver. Install the rack rails. Use upper mounting pins for racks between 16 to 20.25 inches deep and lower mounting pins for racks between 19.75 to 24 inches deep. Connect the USB hub and any SSD cables you may have installed to your Mac Studio. Lock the included Thunderbolt cable with ThunderLock to the Echo module and connect it to the Mac Studio. Connect power cables to the Echo module and Mac Studio. That's it! Your xMac Studio is now ready to be mounted into your rack. xMac Studio, the ultimate Mac Studio rack mount and Thunderbolt to PCIe card expansion system. For more information, watch our product overview video.